Hey everybody, I'm back again with another video. This is my repair of the Akai LPK25 MIDI keyboard. So the first thing you're going to need to do is get an old USB cable and cut off the one end and strip back the wires for soldering. I would recommend that you do no more than a 16th of an inch and pre-solder all the connectors. Now these wire points are super small, so you want to have the smallest soldering iron tip available to you and the finest solder you can find. It's really quick and it's really hard to get those solders on there without making a mess. So red and black are for power and green and white are for data. And R1 is white data, and R2 on the board is green data. And then, of course, black is for your negative ground, and that goes on that first pin on the top part of the board there. And it should have a box around it, which signifies that that's pin 1. Then, of course, white is once again for R1 and green is for R2, and that is your data line, and you have to do it just before the little component there. So if you look and you see on the right hand side, there's the USB or mini USB connector. Now that connector was the reason I'm doing this repair. It got broken off, so when the person put the plug in it, it sheared the connector right off. FB21 is for your red wire, and that goes, if you trace it from the connector, you can see that it says FB21, and you just solder to the first point of that. And you're going to need some really good magnifying, either a magnifying glass or a magnifying glasses to see these points, because like I said, they are super tiny and really, really hard to get on there. I had a little bit of luck. And it worked out pretty good though. So anyway, that's totally it. It works. It saved me about $70. If you like this video, please subscribe. If you didn't like it or whatever, you just leave some comments and I'll try to make it better next time. Thanks for watching.